vegetarianism and veganism, which is becoming very popular. It is a big movement around the world, and in Europe now we have cities which pronounce themselves as being vegetarian or vegan, and lots of vegan restaurants and the rest of them. And the more that's happening, the more practitioners such as myself see a problem. Because I've seen many, many patients, many young people in my clinic who have destroyed themselves with misguided vegetarianism. And I mean destroyed their lives, destroyed their health, destroyed themselves. There is a confusion. Some choose this lifestyle after discovering how industrial agriculture treats animals and birds, which is appalling, absolutely appalling. And there are videos that circulate around the internet where these poor animals are shown how it's all done. And the reaction that the conclusion that these videos lead the audience to is that become a vegetarian. It's bad to eat meat. Stop eating animals. Stop killing animals because it's cruel and so on and so forth. That the right way to fight that system is by becoming a vegetarian. Some believe that this is the healthiest lifestyle, and there are plenty of books written to that effect, very enthusiastic, very evangelical. Some do it for emotional, religious, or political reasons. Some believe that they're saving the planet. Many people really believe that all this pasture and all these animals that are on pasture, if we've taken the animals off the pasture, plowed it all, and we can grow the grain and feed the population of the planet, grain and soya. Rather than feeding all that grain to the animals, we can be feeding it directly to the humans. And of course, that is based on ignorance, which we'll talk about today. Nutritional science adds to the confusion because there is no end of various nutritional scientific papers touting that meat is bad for you, and meat is bad for you, and meat is bad for you, and eggs are bad for you, and animal fats cause everything, every disease under the sun. I remember when I was doing a nutritional course at university in the UK, and I started arguing with my professor about the fats, who was saying that fats cause everything, animal fats. He threatened to throw me off the course. So I had to be quiet on the subject. Doctors see more and more young people damaging their health and destroying their lives through misguided vegetarianism. If you speak to any clinician who sees these patients and works with them, they will say the same thing to you, that they've seen far too many young people who develop mental illness, autoimmune disease, and various other chronic illnesses which destroyed their lives because of vegetarianism. And question is, should we all become vegetarian or vegan? Should the whole population of the planet become vegan or vegetarian? According to the enthusiasts, we should. Because the way they talk about their lifestyle and the way they write their books is they try very hard to make the meat eaters feel guilty about eating animals. They behave themselves with an air of a pious person speaking to a sinner. So let's talk about this and how does it work. We need to understand the basics. And what I find with all of these patients that destroy themselves, that come to my clinic, I find ignorance, profound ignorance. Their beliefs are based on the lack of information, lack of understanding of what they're doing, these people. All energy on our beautiful planet gets recycled, apart from the energy of the sun. The new energy comes on the planet from the sun. In order to capture the energy of the sun and turn it into a solid matter, Mother Nature created plants. Plants have photosynthesis. They can capture the energy of the sun and turn it into something we can touch, or we can eat, and we can cook, which is absolutely amazing. They have photosynthesis. Then in order for something else to consume the energy of the sun in the form of plants, Mother Nature created herbivorous animals.